Hey everyone, welcome to the Hey Teacher series, in which we answer the questions most frequently asked by teachers. You would like to use Odoo, but you don't have the time to complete your database or simply don't have any data available. Well, in this video, I'll show you some alternatives that will enable you to get started with a completed database. Let's have a look together. It's perfectly possible to start using Odoo with an existing database. In fact, there are several possibilities. You can use Odoo's demo database, you can import the same demo data into your own database, and you can copy databases created and shared by teachers. It all depends on your needs. If you want to train with a database that's already been filled in, but don't want to keep the changes you've made, then the demo database is for you. In fact, it's a database that resets itself after each use. It's thus the perfect solution for practicing your Odoo skills without being afraid of making mistakes and clicking where you shouldn't. You can use it as a test database to try out features and understand how the software behaves before doing the same in your own database. You can easily access this demo version at demo.odoo.com. So here is the demo database, and if you click on any app, for instance sales, you'll see it's already filled in. If on the other hand, you want a personal Odoo database with Odoo demo data, you can import it into your database. Please note that once you've done this, you won't be able to go back. To import this data, go to your database and select the settings application. Scroll down to the bottom and click on Activate the Developer Mode. Then, once display returns to the homepage, you go back to the Settings application, again at the very bottom, and click on Load Demo Data. A warning message appears because, as I've already told you, you won't be able to go back once it's done. So you click on Yes, I understand the risks. And as we can see now, if I click on Sales, for instance, the data is in my database. And last but not least, you can also copy a database created by another teacher. A teacher can decide to share his or her database with students, but can also make it available to other teachers if wanted. To access the sharing platform, go to the link that you see on the screen. You can see here the different shared courses, and if you click on one, you'll see the information added by the teacher. Sometimes there is not a lot of information added, as you can see here. This is also where you can duplicate the database as a teacher. But please note that an educational database is only valid for 2 years. So if you copy one that was created several months ago, your copy will be valid for less than 2 years. This is why a warning message sometimes appears, warning that the database will soon be unusable. If you'd like to know more about the validity of educational databases, please have a look at the video on this topic. There you go. You don't have to worry about what data to add to your database anymore. All you have to do now is getting started with your completed database. And if you still have questions, don't hesitate to watch the other videos from the Hey Teacher series. See you soon.